I want to thank everybody for joining us today for Time Billing and AccountEdge, and we're also going to be talking about selling services and service items. So this is really a non-inventory-based webinar, although we're going to touch on it a little bit as relevant. So a quick agenda on what we are going to cover. We're going to talk about some of your support options, discuss service items and service invoices and how you might want to use them to manage your services business, as well as service items and doing item invoices. So you may want to use an item invoice to track and sell your services. So we'll talk about all your options as far as setting up service items. And then we'll get into using time billing and setting up hourly and non-hourly activities, and then applying them on activity slips and timesheets. We'll create some time billing invoices and also talk about managing jobs and reporting. We'll dabble on retainers toward the end, and then we'll also talk about your options about going mobile. So first, let's get into support, just so you know what your options are. We offer 30 days of free introductory telephone support to our new users. This is to help them get their company files set up properly. Our support center is located in our offices in Rockaway, New Jersey, which is about 35 minutes west of New York City. After your 30 days is up, you can choose to purchase an annual telephone plan starting at $199. And if you process payroll on AccountEdge, and this is important, you may want a payroll tax service, which is available with or without telephone support. We want to make sure you have the latest software and especially the latest tax tables, but either way, you'll still get 1-800 telephone support from our New Jersey-based call center. We also have a knowledge base, which has articles and how-tos written by the members of our support team. So if we get calls from customers on certain topics, they'll sit and write these articles, pass them around the office, and we'll post them on our knowledge base. So this comes directly from the support staff who are getting these questions from customers every single day. Visit our YouTube channel where you'll see tutorials and recorded webinars like this one that discuss a lot of different topics related to AccountEdge, whether it's setting it up or the new features available in AccountEdge 2017. We also offer free email support for life. So if you choose not to have a telephone plan, but you just may have a question every once in a while, feel free to use our free email support page where you can get help usually in about a day on any version on either platform for life. So if you just need help once in a while, it's a great option. Again, we just want to make sure you're covered. If you'd like to get help in your office, we have a staff of local certified consultants who are actually independent from us. They're independent contractors, consultants, accountants, and bookkeepers who can come out to your office and help you get AccountEdge up and running and also train your staff. Many of them work remotely, so you can work with them over the internet using screen share tools, and they can help you with the same information. Finally, we offer a free accountant copy of AccountEdge. Because AccountEdge files are cross-platform, that means an AccountEdge company file on your Mac can be opened by your accountant using a PC. So we'll make available an accountant's copy of AccountEdge for your accountant on either platform so they can open up your AccountEdge file no matter which platform you're on. So a few caveats before we get into more information and the actual demonstration. Starting with, you don't have to use all of AccountEdge. I want to show you a bunch of different options and ways to do things, but don't feel like you have to use every portion of AccountEdge. We recommend you get started and solve your most immediate problems first. Start small, start to walk before you figure out how you want to run AccountEdge and run further into the features it offers. Most importantly, use the sample company file to explore for yourself. When you launch AccountEdge from the welcome window, you can actually go directly into the sample company. I'll be using a version of that sample company today, so you'll see a lot of the same cards, items, and other things that you can use directly on your computer. So as far as AccountEdge Pro and time billing, there's a lot we could cover here. We start off with things like activities and create a log and manage service items. So it really depends on how your business is structured and what it is you're selling. Is it services or is it time-based activities? So we're going to go through some demonstrations where we show you a few options for each of those. But it really comes down to how you want to record sales and then how do you want to report out on them. So is it going to be on the item level, at the activity level, or just at the sale level? So for example, if you set up your services as inventory items, which I'll show you in a second, you can then use the inventory reports to find detail on your services. If you're going to use time billing, you can then use all the time billing and activity reports. Or if you just want to record your sales as service items, without tracking your service items, you can just type in the text right into the invoice window and have that be the detail of your service. You'll get the least amount of reporting because you're typing in your own detail when you create the invoice, and we'll talk about that a little bit further. There are pros and cons to using each way of doing it, depending on which sales layout you're recording. So why don't we jump right into AccountEdge and take a look and start to dig into some of your options. So the first thing I'd like to do is just to create a quick service transaction, just to get a flavor for how it can work. So the first thing we'll do is we'll click on the Sales Command Center, and then we'll click on Enter Sales. From here, I'll start to type in the customer I want to use, Acme Sales. AccountEdge will alert me that there's pre-existing transactions, existing quotes and orders I've already created, but I'm going to create an entirely new transaction. So I'll click on the New button. From here, you'll notice that I'm in a service sales window. That's because when I set up Acme Sales, I define them as a customer that I typically sell services to. I can always override that by selecting the Layout button at the bottom of the screen and overriding that default setting and selecting any of the other options. So for now, let's just do a service sale, and we'll follow through by tabbing through the fields, letting AccountEdge assign the invoice number using today's date, their default terms, etc. And now we're just going to type in or copy and paste in the details of the services I provided and the price. If I want to apply this to a job or a department, I can do that as well. So at this point, this invoice is basically ready to go. I have it set as my delivery status to be emailed. This way, when I go to print all of my open invoices, it'll actually allow me to email this invoice out to the customer. I also have the option of printing it if I want to send them a printed copy or do both. So if I click on Send Email, it'll record the transaction, and it'll show me what the mail merged email will look like. So in this example, I use one of our new email features to create a template for a sales invoice, and then in the body of the email itself, I'll see the invoice number, the date, the amount of the invoice, which includes my sales tax, and the due date. I can always include any attachments with this, and I'll also see that I'm using the form, the MOCA service sale. So if I open it up, I can actually view this email as if my customer was going to receive it. So you'll see the mail merged email as well as the form itself on the bottom. So that's a quick way to send out an email or send out an invoice that's a service invoice. So let's take a couple of steps back and look at how we got to that point and how we can add more detail. So you notice that when I created the invoice, I just typed or pasted in my description and created the invoice right from there. I talked about setting up service items. Why don't we go ahead and look at that? So if we open up our Inventory Command Center, and I'll click on my item list. So normally you would think of items as things you inventory and sell from inventory or manufacture and track how many you have and how many you need to purchase, you know, the moving of goods through your business and to your customers. And that's all totally true. But you can also use AccountEdge to use inventory to manage the services you sell. So here, for example, my very first item is called a typical service. And if you look at it, there's no quantity on hand and no cost. That tells me right away that this is not something I'm stocking, so it's a service item. Whereas all my other items, like coffee filters, have quantities on hand and costs and selling prices. So if I drill into my typical service, you'll see I have it set up, and in the Profile tab, I've only selected one checkbox, the I Sell This Item checkbox. This will tell AccountEdge that this is an item that you can use on invoices, but it won't ask you to purchase them because you're not tracking inventory, and you don't have to worry about having enough on hand to make any transactions for sales, and it won't worry you with keeping quantity on hand based on purchases you may have to make from specific vendors, like you would with a normal inventoried item. So in this case, I'm tracking just the fact that I sell this item, and I'm assigning it to a default general ledger account. I can put in some additional item details, like here I have for professional services rendered, and I can use all the other features involved with my inventory item information window, like my three custom lists, my three custom fields, and don't forget, you can change the names or the labels of these fields and lists just by going to the list menu and modifying them up here. I can also define my selling detail, so when I sell my service, I can define what my base selling price is. And there's some other options here for quantity breaks, but we're not going to worry about that for services. So at this point, I've already created most of the information that I need. And let's go ahead and do a transaction for that item. So again, we'll come back to our Sales Command Center. We'll click on a sale and we'll type in Acme. We'll override the existing pre-existing transactions to create a new one. But in this case, we're going to override the layout and choose item. So now we're going to sell one of this service item. So here you see in my select from list, it's the very first item, and I'll just select use item. So we're shipping a quantity of one, but if I wanted to get into price discounts, I could have done that when I set the item up. So here, since I'm just selling one, it'll put in the base price, which is $125. So again, you can modify this. You could override the description, put in more detail, assign a location or a separate price, or even a discount for this line item. You can apply it to one or many jobs, apply it to one or many departments, and tell us if this service is taxable or not taxable, and if so, which sales tax rate you're going to charge. So we're going to skip over all those features, and again, create basically the same transaction we did a minute ago. The only difference is now we're selling something in inventory. So because we're using an inventory item sales layout, we can then go to use some of the inventory reports that'll let us see how many of this service we actually sold. So that's when you get into the next level of detail by setting up your recurring services, or services you use quite often, maybe not necessarily recurring, but services that you may sell all the time. And if you have a case like that, I recommend setting up those services as items, unless they're based on time, and we'll get into the time billing aspect in a second. So before we go ahead and record this transaction, just want to show you my favorite feature in AccountEdge, which is the recap transaction, which is Command R. And you can get this under the Edit menu and click Command R. Same thing on the Windows platform. It'll show you the debits and credits for this transaction. So we're going to go ahead and say okay to this and record the transaction. Again, the same deal. We can email this out, print it out, or do both. So now let's dig into the next level of detail, assuming that you're going to be using activities. So activities gets a little bit more involved. It's a little bit more set up than I just showed you as it relates to service items using inventory. But in our time billing command center, let's click on the activities list. So the activities list is basically your building blocks of not only your timesheets, but also your invoices. So here you'll see a series of activities. Some are hourly types, some are non-hourly types. So things like a private event, it's something that you do by a quantity or a photocopy or a mile. Those are non-hourly events, as opposed to something you may charge by the quarter hour, half hour, or full hour. We also have a status of an item, which can mark it as chargeable or non-chargeable. So you might ask, why would you even have an activity that you're not going to charge for? So a good scenario would be, or might be, in case where you have your employees fill out a timesheet and you want to make sure they're accounting for all 8 hours in their day. So you may actually want to set up something like a break or a meal as something that you don't charge for. So in my first example, in this first activity, it's a non-chargeable activity. So we'll drill into it and you'll see there's not a whole lot of detail required here. Just the ID and the name. I can give it a full description. Because it's an hourly type, by default, the unit of measure is an hour. And I have the status set to non-chargeable. So that means, again, my employee can use that on a timesheet. But when it comes to billing my customers, when I prepare my time billing invoices, these activities won't be available for billing. So it's a great way to track internal time versus non-chargeable customer time. On the flip side, I have a second activity set up called Break. Let's drill into that one just to show you some of the differences. This one is also hourly, but it's marked as chargeable. Because of that, I can determine which rate I'd like to use. So in AccountEdge, you can define a default billing rate for your customer, for your employee, or for the activity itself. So in this case, I'm going to use the activity rate, which is $100. So no matter who does this task, we're going to charge the same amount, no matter which the employee I assign to the job. Again, I can define whether it's taxable or not taxable. And because it's an hourly item, it's a unit of measure set up as an hour. So why don't we go ahead and show you a couple different ways to capture your time using the activity list. The first one would be to use the activity slip itself. And we'll type in our employee. So I'll type in BE and Charles Berenger comes up. And we'll put in today's date and we'll also put in the Acme sales customer, and then I can select the activity that I'm performing. So maybe in this case, I want to record the fact that I spent an hour on my lunch. If I have some other notes I'd like to type in, I can do that here. And at the bottom, there's also an integrated timer, which allows you to start and stop the clock. So maybe you're working on a Photoshop project and you're doing it throughout the day. So the best way to keep time in real time is to use the timer built into AccountEdge and let that help you accumulate the units, which will then turn your activity slips into full-on chargeable time. So at this point, I can go ahead and create an invoice if I click on the Create Invoice button specifically for this activity. So this is a great option if you don't want to go through the next couple of steps, which is then to take your work in progress, figure out what you want to bill your customers. So maybe you do month-end billing. So in that case, you would just record the transaction, and at the month-end, when you're ready to do all of your client billing, you would come in and do the next step, and that next step would be to prepare the time billing invoice. But before we do that, let's go ahead and create a couple other activity slips and timesheets. Again, we'll use Charles, we'll use the same customer, but now we're going to use different activities. So in this case, maybe Charles had to travel on site to do some work, and he traveled 300 miles. Don't forget, you can also create a mileage slip in AccountEdge, but in this case, we have an activity set up for mileage itself. And because we put in a number of miles, maybe we're not going to charge a per visit rate. So I could also override that and put in maybe 50 cents per mile. So really, you're just playing with the math at this point. Or if I just want to say it's one unit at the default $300 or $25 per visit, again, you can play with the math. You can always assign it to single or multiple jobs and departments, and then put in whatever notes you may have. So if Charles has detailed notes for this specific visit, not only can he log them right into the activity slip, but he could tell AccountEdge to use those notes when he creates the invoice. On the right side of this screen, this is a great option for the person doing your billing who can then drill into the activity slips and make adjustments, or you could let your employee or subcontractor do this as well if you give them access directly to AccountEdge. So from here, I might be able to override some of this and realize that I can't really bill for this entire hour, so I may mark it down by a half an hour. I could do that in dollars as well. So again, we're going to go ahead and record and let it go from there. So now that we've recorded all the time and activity slips, you may also have employees who are going to be doing timesheets. So let's go ahead and look at Charles Berenger's timesheet. Now in a timesheet, I can apply this time to a payroll category. So you might be using timesheets not to bill your customers necessarily, but more for payroll purposes where you want to make sure your employees are on the clock or have taken vacation time, etc. So in this case, we're just going to use his base hourly. We'll put in an activity in this case, and we'll also assign it to a customer and then put in the number of hours per day. And I can copy a timesheet from week to week, again, making it easier if I am doing this for a job that lasts several months, or again, if it's just for straight on payroll and you want to make sure you're accumulating your 40 hours a week, that is going to be your salary. So I'll click OK, and again, that's just another way to enter detail as far as timesheets. And now we'll click on Prepare Time Billing Invoice. And this is basically taking all of your work in progress, all the work you've already done but not yet billed, and looking at it on one worksheet, which is this window here. So from the Prepare Time Billing Invoice, we can look at all the existing activity slips and timesheet cells, meaning each individual day, and figure out which ones we actually want to bill. So maybe we want to come through and just bill some of these activities here, and we can just click them off, and we can also override whatever we want to override, and we can make some adjustments. So again, you have the option of doing all this at the time, and this is why you want to use the pre-billing worksheet, and you can also work in dollars or units. So if it's easier to you to work in units, just click the radio button, and it'll change the window to allow you to enter data as it relates to these activity slips and timesheets from the dollars or units perspective. And if you just want to work on one customer or one specific job, you can use the filters at the top of this window rather than seeing everything for everybody. One of the other checkboxes I want to point out is at the bottom here. It says consolidate activities on invoice. This is really helpful if you have multiple people performing the same task. And after doing it over days or weeks coming from your timesheets, you may not want your invoice to show on site or coffee 101 or whatever the activity is. You know, you may not want that on your invoice, you know, each individual time they did it. So you can consolidate those activities. So if multiple people did them, you'll end up seeing one line item for the activity itself. So let's go ahead and just create the invoice. I'll click on Prepare Invoice. And now it opens up a time billing invoice. So this is another one of the invoice options we had. So when I clicked on Layout, we started with a service invoice. And then we did an item invoice, and now we're down into a time billing invoice. I'll touch on professional invoices in a second. But basically at this point, we've brought over all the information from the various activity slips and timesheets and brought it into the invoice screen. There's a bunch of other stuff you can do at this point. If you've got expenses on behalf of your customers, you can actually mark those up and invoice them. And you can also use AccountEdge to sell time and materials on the same transaction. So if you wanted to actually sell something out of your inventory, you'll see in my time billing invoice, I actually have access to my complete inventory list. So maybe in this example, I want to sell them a frothing thermometer. So I may have performed several tasks to help them get their coffee bar set up, and I'm also going to sell them the material they need. In this case, I'm just going to assign a serial number to this item because it's required. And now that'll let me put in on the same transaction my time and my materials. You'll also be able to use some of the tricks in AccountEdge. So if I look at AccountEdge and I look at the edit menu, I can insert or delete a line within a transaction. And I can also insert a header or a subtotal. So maybe I want to have all of my time and then a subtotal and then all of my items and another subtotal. So for example, let's say we want to insert a line, and from this line, we want to insert a subtotal. So now you'll see a subtotal for all the items above it. And then we'll do the same thing on the line below my item. So now you start to create the building blocks of your invoice, separating the time from the actual items, if you're going to commingle those on the same transaction. Again, I'll point out that I'm using a time billing invoice, which allows me to create an invoice with items and activities. I don't do that on an item invoice. I have to use a time billing invoice. But again, it's a great way to show time and materials on the same transaction. I'm going to go ahead and hit record. And in the background, of course, all the debits and credits take care of themselves because that's the cool part of AccountEdge. You don't have to worry about that. And then we're going to go ahead and record everything. We're not going to worry about our quantity on hand or the credit we have for this customer. We're just going to go ahead and record a brand new sale. I also wanted to touch on retainers. So if you're in the business where you actually managed retainers, that's something you can also do directly from the Sales Command Center within AccountEdge. So if I click on Retainers, Escrows, and Trusts, you'll see we have three set up. Again, this is directly from the sample company file, so you can play with these as well. If I drill into the Carolina retainer, you'll see some of the information required to set up a retainer. And the first step is just to determine whether it's a retainer, escrow, or trust. And from here, you can determine the optional replenishment information. So if the customer gets below a certain level, AccountEdge will prompt you. Maybe you want to send them an email and have them send you a check to get them up to a minimum balance and then be able to continue on your work with them. You can also receive money into a retainer or spend money from a retainer. So maybe you incurred some expenses. So maybe you need to write a check to FedEx or UPS because of some contracts you had to mail out. So you can actually click on the Spend Retainer button, which will open up the Spend Retainer window, of course, allowing you to write a check to anybody in your card file and have that money be applied to the retainer itself. So there's a bunch of different ways that you can record time in AccountEdge, whether you're using service items, actual physical inventory items set up as service items, or using activities and time billing. There's also a couple other options I wanted to talk about. So if you're going to be going mobile, we have two tools that might make your life easier. The first one is AccountEdge Mobile, which is an iOS application, which just got updated in the last week. But AccountEdge Mobile allows you to create service sales and time billing sales, just like I just showed you. You can also create activity slips, and you have other options available in AccountEdge Mobile, including customizable transaction IDs that you can't do in AccountEdge. So it makes it easy to set up different invoicing numbering schemes using them on your various iOS devices. So maybe you have multiple people in the field creating activity slips or creating time invoices or service invoices, and you want to set up specific transaction IDs from each user. So you can do that from AccountEdge Mobile and then have those transaction numbers flow right into AccountEdge. So again, AccountEdge Mobile is a free app available on Apple's iOS store. You can create sales activity slips, spend money transactions, create mileage slips, and manage receivables. And here's an example of an item sale. Again, very same information you would have recorded in AccountEdge itself. And you can also add and edit any of your cards, and it'll all be synced back to AccountEdge. So that's AccountEdge Mobile. It's a free service available for your iPhone or iPod. We also have a service called AccountEdge Connect, and it too does a lot of the same processes, the same transactions. But with AccountEdge Connect, you can use any web-enabled device. So again, you can do service and professional sales, item sales, activity slips, and timesheets. And again, you can apply those to payroll categories using AccountEdge Connect. You can manage and track jobs, use our integrated timer, and a whole bunch of other features. So from AccountEdge Connect, when you create a transaction, you can create and select whatever layout you'd like and the type you would like, just like I showed you in AccountEdge on the desktop. And all those transactions will also sync automatically back down to AccountEdge. And then every day when you launch AccountEdge, you can just select the sync button and we'll bring in all the latest transactions and send up all the latest details from AccountEdge on your desktop, making them available in AccountEdge Connect for your vendors or subcontractors or employees to create transactions. So that was a brief overview of how to use AccountEdge to manage services and time. We hope you found something helpful for your business. We'll remain on the line for a few more minutes, and Lauren will continue to answer questions as best we can. If you need access to get more help, feel free to call our service center at 800-322-6962 for customer service, and they'll tell you what your options are to get more help. You can visit our AccountEdge website and go to the Start Here page if you're brand new with AccountEdge, and it's a great way to get your foot in the door and start setting up AccountEdge. You can drop us an email or, again, visit our YouTube channel and look for our various playlists with dozens of videos about AccountEdge in any situation. We appreciate you spending some time with us today. Again, we'll remain on the line for a little bit longer. Thanks, everybody, for joining us, and thank you, Lauren, for managing everything in the back end. Have a great day and Happy New Year.